What's this episode called? I forgot. Oh, custody law and Eastern European diplomacy.
That sounds like a lot.
Not that much. All right, we're back.
We're back.
What were they talking about? Oh, custody law and Eastern European diplomacy.
Yay.
All right, so we start off baby shower.
Two gifts?
Thank you.
Well, I wanted to get the baby a doll, and since the father might be Andre or Chang, I wanted all ethnic bases covered. So,
oh my God.
There's a little African-American girl. And there's a very nice letter from the manufacturer promising to expand their selection.
Fair.
That's really funny. Baby shower.
Yeah. How do we feel about baby showers?
They're so fucking boring. I think baby showers.
But
boring.
Like the purpose of them, because like you get stuff.
Yes, I think it's good as a community to gather and help relieve the burden. And financial strain that babies place on families. So, yeah, concept, great. How about I just mail it instead of showing up and then sitting uncomfortably as somebody tries to think of a game to play and then me have to try to talk to people I don't want to talk to? That's how I feel about that.
I remember one that I went to when I was a kid, and we had it at, like, a pottery. It wasn't the pottery bar, but, like, a pottery place.
Yeah.
And instead they got us kids to just, like, make, like, they got, like, like these little like gingerbread shaped things, and then we just painted them, and we had to paint like if we thought it was like a boy or a girl.
Yeah.
So that was the game, which is fun for kids.
Yeah, that is fun.
Like I think if you make it like simple and just maybe like a tiny like party thing, and then just have gifts.
Right.
I don't think you need games, honestly.
Just, no. Like, just food, and I just don't want to have to show up for that long. Just hey, how's it going? Here's your present. Give me some lunch. Okay, bye. But that's just me.
Anyway, so basically the gang made a baby shower for Shirley in the study room. And I guess, like, for Shirley and Andre and Chang, even though we don't know who the father is.
Mm-hmm.
Can you, like, figure it out at this point? Like, with, like, amniocentesis?
You have to actually, like, isn't that an invasive procedure, though?
I thought it wasn't that invasive. I think, like, it's invasive, but I don't think it's, like, damaging
okay.
to the fetus.
It's probably just not worth it at this point in time.
Are you saying Law & Order SVU lied to me?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think we desperately want to know.
Yeah.
Because, like, I feel like this anxiety about, like, is the father of your child this man you love, or is it Chang?
But if we know, then where's the drama there? Where's the drama of it all?
Anyway, so they're kind of, like, it's a mix of, like, it's very, like, race-based.
Annie, you are aware the baby shower is going to be race-neutral?
Yes, thank you, Annie, for trying to be inclusive, but regardless of any biological happenstance.
Zombie!
This baby will be raised by Andre and I.
That's right. Now, I seem to recall a story about a man named Joseph who happily raised a baby that wasn't his.
History's greatest chump. We're talking about Joe Kennedy, right?
Cool. It's mine. I'll be a lovable uncle.
I know.
Hey, do people eat this stuff?
I've never seen that stuff in my life.
You know, you really shouldn't say you people.
Oh, it's okay. Pierce was having trouble quitting offensive phrases cold turkey, so we've created a bargaining system. We traded you people for some of his other favorite phrases.
Yeah, I really got Jewish personed out of that one.
That's terrible.
Progress?
Progress?
Oh.
Yeah, everyone is like, you know, talking about like African culture and like Chinese culture. It is unfortunately very racial.
And, like, but anyway, so, like, and the food is very much, like, Facebook.
Yeah.
And the one present is, I think, from, I think it's mainly from, like, Annie, is, they get, like, a doll for the baby. That's the weird thing, like, if you don't know what, like, I mean, I know, like, you know, gender is subjective and, like, but, like, yeah. I kind of don't mind if, like, for, like, if you're finding out, like, what a baby's gender is, because kind of just, like, they'll figure it out like later. They want to change it later.
I think gender reveal parties are stupid, and I'll stand by this. Fight me.
That I agree with. That I do agree with, but I kind of like if you like want to find out just for like to get like certain stuff, but then I'm like you could probably see like neutral based clothing.
Yeah, that babies don't care. Clothing was gender neutral until the 80s, and it became a marketing thing. So the only reason why baby clothes are actually like
yeah, like
gendered,
technically like
it's a capitalism.
I feel like most like toys are neutral, except like even like
it was until the 80s, and there was a really stark divide about like about like gendering items like clothes and toys because it just became a way to like market, and so you know then. You can market and like hyper focus on a demographic instead of having general things. So it's actually the reason we have gender for children is capitalism.
Capitalism.
So, and you can look this up. I'm not wrong. So
basically, like, buy them gender neutral toys or like a mix of both.
Yeah.
Female male toys, and then let them decide when they get older.
Yeah, man. Yeah. They're gonna play with what they want to play with.
And then I guess like the other thing is if you want to pick a name.
Yeah,
but
I mean,
like that kind of, and then like then
the names are names. Like you just gotta try your best.
God, I have like so much anxiety about like whenever if I have a kid, I have so much anxiety about like if people are gonna get mad at me because I decided to do this, and I'm like, wait, why did they?
They don't matter.
Like if I want to find out if I want to give my like child like a gender specific name and then they want to change it later, I'm not gonna care.
Right. Yeah.
As long as I give them love.
Right.
And they don't mess with my psyche.
Yeah. Nobody mess with anybody's psyche, please. Thank you.
Including mine.
Yes. Yes.
Because as Kaylin knows, it's not very fragile.
It's okay. I know this and I love you.
Where did you get this? Sorry, I got really distracted by your jacket because I really like it.
Do you like my jacket?
Well, I've always had on like a hood thing like that on a jacket.
H&M.
Nice.
Got it a few years ago, so. Anyway.
Anyway. Community, sorry.
All right, here we go. Baby showers.
I know. Sorry. I think it's funny when I talk about my psyche sometimes. Anyway. So one of the gifts is like a doll with like that's like a little black girl.
Like an American Girl doll.
Which like that's expensive.
But yeah. Yes, but American Girl dolls are wonderful.
No, I love them.
I'm pro American Girl.
Me too, because like they actually learn about history.
Mm-hmm.
You only had one, right? You had Christy?
I had two. No.
No, you had Addie.
I had Addie. Yes, I had Addie and I had Felicity.
Felicity, right.
Yes. So those were my two.
Nobody had Christy? Here's a Kirsten.
Kirsten. I did not have Kirsten, even though I looked most like Kirsten when I was a kid. Because I had very long blonde hair. And I was tall like a Swede.
I got Molly, who I most look like, let's be honest. And then I got Kaya.
Yeah. Good stuff.
Yeah, I think we talked about this before, but like.
But American Girl, man.
I'm gonna go on that trip too.
You wanna go on what trip?
To go to the American Girl doll place.
That'd be fun, actually.
We'll go to the Watergate Hotel.
Yeah.
Say, oh, that's Patreon, please.
Please give us money so we can go on all these trips. Thank you.
Anyway, we get the gifts, and then it's kind of like Chang's like kind of like trying to insert his way a little bit into like what's going on with like you're like trying to be like a father figure, but like Shirley and Audrey are kind of like nope.
Right, like, this is our baby, and regardless of who the biological parent is, this is our baby.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I remember, like, reading somewhere, like, apparently, like, if, it's like, I think it's, like, I'm not going to say, because I don't actually remember the full thing, and I'm not sure if it's legal.
Okay, all right.
I don't want to get legal comments in my...
Yeah, that's fine.
So that's going on, and then the dean comes in, and he's, like, in a stereotypical Chinese outfit.
Yeah. Sure.
Sorry, I'm late.
Can I get a knee how up in the scissors?
No.
Why is everyone in this school obsessed with
white people problems?
Ooh, that looks nice.
Oh, Troy, Abed, who's that cute guy that I saw you outside with earlier?
Oh, that's Luca. That's our new friend. He's in Troy's history class.
Oh, yeah, he's awesome. He has an accent, he rolls his own cigarettes, and he plays the same video games as us.
Nice.
We like him a lot. So you're not allowed to bone him.
You just guaranteed you'll bone him.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to think. I don't remember what he looked like.
No, yeah, because remember he had like I don't know the name of the hat.
Oh yeah, yeah. But yes, so that's how we do things here. Is just weirdly racialize everything.
Yeah.
In Greendale, this has been a point before because I think Jeff says it multiple occasions. It's like in the effort to be inclusive, it's a little too makes too much of a point.
You're right.
But it's funny. Anyway.
And then also, Britta, so that's, like, sort of, like, one, well, that's, like, the beginning of one plot point, and the other one is Britta is asking Troy and Abed about this guy that he's hanging out with named Luca.
Yeah.
Because he thinks that he's cute, and then they're like, oh, yeah, he's really cool, you can't date him.
Yeah, they are strongly opposed to Britta dating anyone that they know.
Mainly because Britta ruins the guys for them, and then they never want to hang out with them again.
Mm-hmm. Because, yeah, Britta, as soon as she learns something, that's a red flag, like, she will share it.
Right, but Britta's kind of like, oh, whatever.
Oh, is this a bad time?
Yes.
Gentlemen, there's no way to treat a girl that looks this way.
Yeah, bone it.
Britta,
Like Britney Spears.
Exactly like Britney Spears. Hit me with your genius bottle. Rub it on.
I don't think it works like that, honey.
I mean, the fact that it's Christina Aguilera?
No, stay.
You mean the fact that that's Christina Aguilera? Anyway.
But, like, also not.
Yes, I'm cooking.
Okay, I'll give you my number.
Oh! You are her boyfriend?
Yeah!
I love these guys. They make funny with their mouths.
What? He asked me out.
You're not allowed.
Not allowed?
You'll ruin him.
I'll ruin him.
Stop repeating.
Stop reprimanding me and explain why I'll ruin him.
Tell us horrible things about them that we can never unhear.
Name one guy I did that with.
Carl, Todd, one Kyle, dude, tall Kyle, Jeff.
Jeff? I ruined Jeff?
Oh, you mean Jeff Nipple Play Winger? No, as you can see, we're still hanging out with him. How's it going, Jeff?
Promise me you won't date Luca and I'll give you one of these. It's a sweatshirt I made for everyone who was part of the paintball adventure last year.
Don't date Luca.
Get my genie bottle.
What was that?
Oh, their baby. So then she kind of goes to the dorm room one day to sort of like, and like when Luca's there to kind of like introduce herself.
Mm-hmm.
And then we meet Luca. Oh, I forgot the name of the actor. But like he's been in stuff.
Okay.
I'll.
Sure, we'll find out.
We'll find out. I know he's in, like, he was like kind of played like dickheads.
Okay.
Except for in Dollhouse, which is like a terrible show, but he was like one of the better parts of Dollhouse.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, so, Britta's kind of, like, flirting with him a bit, and then that's when we kind of get the reveal of, like, you ruined, like, Jeff for us with nipple play.
Yes, because they name all of the men that Britta has ruined for them, including Jeff, because now they know that he's in a nipple play, and you have to eat some separation after that one.
Yeah.
So, like, fair.
So Britta's kind of like, whatever. And then we cut back to one day later in the hallway. Shirley runs into Jeff, and she's got, like, this form. Mm-hmm. And it says, I need you to get Cheng to sign this. It's basically custody form, like, giving up his parental rights.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, pieces of paper stapled together, a lot of writing. I'm afraid this is as far as I can go.
No, I don't want you to read it, Jeff. I want you to help me get Cheng to sign it. It's a little something-something I had an attorney draw up.
This little something-something is a forfeiture of parental rights?
Mm-hmm, better safe than sorry.
Why do you need me to make Cheng sign away his hypothetical baby?
Isn't he sort of living with you?
Not cool, Shirley.
You have a rapport with him. And
not cool, Shirley. I don't see Cheng as being a real hands-on baby daddy.
Hmm. So now we're all in the business of knowing what's going on in Cheng's head, huh? Huh?
Fine. For the child.
God bless you.
Not lately.
It'd be like that, Jeff. It sure do be like that.
Like, and like, basically, Shirley's trying to convince, try to tell Jeff to get Cheng to sign it. And he's kind of like, ugh, fine.
Mm-hmm.
So then at the apartment, because Cheng's still kind of living with Jeff, which, like, good for Jeff?
I don't think Jeff likes any of it, but he just puts up with it at this point, as he does with most things in life.
So, at the apartment, Jeff's just kind of like, dude, sign this.
I was going to, but I noticed your coffee table is wobbly, so I decided to fix it.
How'd that go?
Must be the floor. Don't saw the floor. Don't saw anything.
Parental rights? You're adopting me?
For Shirley. You give her and Andre the baby. Sign it. Oh, and if anyone asks, this was my most convincing speech ever. Oh, don't tell me you actually wanted to be a father.
Oh, no. Maybe.
Should have said sign it, or else I'm kicking you out.
This is my last chance. I mean, between you and me, I don't chang a lot of chicks.
Your fathers are responsible.
So you're saying if I get a job in my own apartment, Shirley might let me be part
of... We don't even know it's your baby.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Also, like, can we think it's actually really nice of Jeff that Chang's been here this long?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Jeff just accepts.
Where do you keep getting these?
And then I pretend I gave you a good speech about signing it, but then Cheng's upset because he kind of wants to be a father.
Yeah.
Even though he's probably going to be terrible at it.
Yeah, because he can't barely manage himself. I feel like there has been, like, this de-evolution of Cheng's character from being, like, just kind of a putz of a professor to just being, like, absolute chaos, insane person who somehow is breathing and we don't know how.
I mean, to be fair, he did fake his way into a job. So maybe that was, like, the only thing I was keeping him productive.
Right. Yeah, because he's devolved a bit.
I feel like because he keeps, like, losing stuff. Like, he lost his job, and then but then he became a student, so that kind of helped a bit.
Yeah.
And then his wife picked him up because she found out about Charlie. Mm-hmm. So I feel like he keeps losing stuff and then he's falling apart.
Yeah.
And then Jeff's kind of like, dude, like, you don't even, like, literally, like, you're crashing on my couch and you don't even have a job.
Right.
So, like, why do you think you'd be a good father? And then he's, and then Chang's like, so you're saying if I get an apartment and a job, then Charlie want me to be a part of my baby's life? And then Jeff wanting Chang out is like, yes.
Yeah, exactly. But yes.
Yes. Meanwhile, Britta and Luca go on a date. Mm-hmm. And then they're like, I think we said it was an apartment because that couch was too nice.
Yeah.
And they're kind of getting, it's a little bit hot and heavy.
Yeah.
Could you just not tell Troy and I
that, that
we went out tonight?
Look at that couch.
It's just,
I don't think it's
true. Just really worried if you and I
that
it
is an apartment?
See each other, that it somehow.
I hope so. I think it's an apartment.
That's a too nice couch for a dorm.
Don't worry. Yeah. Don't worry.
I knew there was pain in there. Just so you know, you can talk to me about
oh, anything. Honey.
So much killing.
So much killing.
The corpses stacked like firewood. The river.
This is only going to end up well.
I miss it so much.
Yeah.
Like you have survivor's guilt. Like you wish you were back over there defending the motherland, right?
Yes, I miss cleansing our fields and forests of the unclean people who stole my country. I miss the smell of the villages burning.
Oh my god.
I miss the way they used to run from our tanks in fear. Ah, oh, damn it. My neighbor is jazz musician.
So do we tell Jory and Ahmed?
What are you doing?
That's a great question.
You look for a job today?
But, and then she's like, hey, like, don't tell Jory and Ahmed, yada, 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 they're having a good time.
Yeah.
And then, Luca's like, yeah, I know what it's like to keep secrets, because he's from the Balkans.
Yeah.
And, Britta's like, He's Eastern European. And then Britta thinking, like, oh no, like, what was I gonna say, like, oh, like, he's pain, he's tortured.
Yes. This poor baby man who just has some trauma.
He's tortured, it's every woman's dream!
Yeah. Anyway,
And he's not in therapy, so we can fix him!
We can fix him!
Yes! Anyway, and he's just like, I don't know if I can do it, sorry. Like, oh yes, the fighting, the slaughtering. I miss it so much.
Right. And so he goes from, right, like, obviously recounting this horrible trauma that he's been through to being on an interesting side of it.
So, turns out he's a bit of a war criminal.
He's kind of a war criminal. Was kind of involved in some genocide.
Oh.
On the delivering end of it.
Oy.
Oy vey.
Misses all of the baby screaming and...
Oh no!
The village was running in fear. I don't know what I'm doing.
That's
funny. I think I went to like some kind of like French thing.
That's okay. Oh no!
And so Britta's like, oh no, I found a red flag. Do I tell Troy and Ahmed?
It's not just a red flag.
That's like
it's a flag that is doused in the blood of innocent civilians.
Right. So like maybe.
Yeah, like maybe we should separate that.
And I do love the part where, like, his neighbor's, like, playing, like, trombone.
Wah, wah, wah.
And then he's like, damn it, man, I've got a woman in here. He really knows how to kill a moose.
Yep. Yeah, that's what killed the moose.
Not the war crime. Not the genocide.
It's not the genocide.
We're just talking about genocide in our Patreon stuff.
That's true. Patreon. If you want to know what we're talking about, no other context.
Nope. Anyway.
Surely, I gave my most convincing speech ever, and it didn't take.
Didn't take? You're not giving him a perm, Jeff. We just need him to sign a contract.
What need is a strong word. I think Shirley would feel more comfortable if we had something in writing. However, I believe that we can handle whatever obstacle comes our way.
Aww. Aww. The next day in the cafeteria, Jeff runs into Shirley and Andre. And she asks, like, oh, do you get the paper side? And, like, I think, like, Andre is kind of being more, like, I don't know, like, understanding is the right word, but, like...
Andre, I think it feels like he has a lot to make up for
in his life,
which he does. So he is often trying to take the role of, like, understanding voice of reason who is trying to be very humble about everything.
Right.
So, and unfortunately, with just the absolute chaos that exists with the main cast of characters, is very much needed. So that's unfortunate.
So then, like, Jeff's like, oh, I tried everything, but it didn't work. Mm-hmm. And then, So then, and then Charlie's kind of like it's just not getting us out of papers. And then Andre's kind of like, we don't need, I mean, we don't technically need it, but, like, it's kind of nice.
Yeah, like, he's like, listen, we're just going to take whatever comes at us. So,
you like, know, honestly, like, I think, like, if it turned out to be Chang Xavier, I think, like, he'd be fine if they were trying to figure out, like, a custody thing.
Yeah.
But then, anyway, then Chang comes in, like, Mr. Rogers-esque.
Oh, my God. Chang! Morning, oh, Chang. Oh, Chang. Oh,
damn. I'm just getting my act together. I got a baby coming.
I can almost hear the pitter-patter of the Chinese feet across the treetops. And when that happens, I've got to be the best dad I can be.
Oh, my God, honey.
Right, Jeff? Huh?
Oh, you're in trouble now, Jeff.
You're in trouble.
Oh, hey, is that a reason to leave?
Yeah, trying to be a 1950s dad type mixed with Mr. Rogers.
Except Mr. Rogers, I don't think smoked. Maybe not.
No.
Maybe at some point.
Not on PBS.
No. So, and then Shirley kind of figures out that, like, oh, like, basically the conversation they had was just a check it out at Jeff's place, and then Shirley's mad at him.
Yeah.
Jeffrey! I know you're not gonna make a pregnant woman walk this distance between us. Very cute, Jeff. But how cute is it gonna be when that lunatic is dangling my baby over a lion cage on alternate weekends?
That'd be pretty cute. Are they baby lions?
No, Jeff. Even for you.
Surely. Right. I'm not gonna make a pregnant woman storm off.
Mm-mm. That's fair. And I do, like, a thing saying, like, I know you're not going to make a pregnant woman run. Mm-hmm. I know you're not going to make her walk this distance.
Yeah.
I wouldn't make a pregnant woman stomp away. No.
Mm-mm.
And then also, like, later on, Chang and Andre kind of have a chat about being a father.
Yeah.
And I, like, and he's like, I was a father for 11 years, and I was good for 9 of them.
Like, there's a level of self-awareness there, but, like, were you? I mean, you admitted to it, so we'll just continue on.
Can I give you some advice, dad to dad?
Aww.
Hold on. What's on your mind, neighbor?
I think it's great that you're trying to get your life together, right? But for your sake and for Shirley's, I think you just need to relax a little.
Oh, I see what's going on.
Yeah.
You're scared. Family coming up on your tail, huh?
No. Man, listen. I've been a father for 11 years, and a good one for 9 of them. Now I'm there when they're sick. I pick them up from school, help them with the homework.
He's honest?
Saying, it's not how you act. It's what you do.
You think that pool table put aluminum siding on itself?
Yeah. See, that's not what I'm talking about. I'll go ahead and consider that point missed.
Yeah. A for effort?
I'm not gonna think about that.
I mean, like, I guess, like, there's no complaints about him being a father.
Yeah, that's true.
I feel like he left at one point. So that
yeah,
kind of,
and that
I feel
was
like,
bad.
It kind of thinks, like, the last, like, few years.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway. So then there's that. And then also, Britta's kind of worried about trying out and hang out with Luca.
Yeah.
But she doesn't want to tell him because she doesn't want to do the thing that they say that she's doing.
Because Britta has a reputation for ruining everything.
But,
and
like,
she tries to resist it sometimes, but doesn't always work out.
War criminal.
Yeah.
Hey guys, where are you going?
We're grabbing lunch for a marathon video game session with Luca. Lots of fork foods. Don't want to grease up the troops.
Did you start dating him and now you want to tell us horrible things about him?
What? No.
Good, because Luca's going to teach us how to break the will of an entire village by killing their livestock and desecrating their places of worship.
That sounds horrific.
Ugh, girls are so undesensitive.
Yeah.
So she wants to try to figure out a way around it rather than just being like...
And he's like, yeah, like, we're going to go play this game and like, apparently, like, Luca told us the best way to like kill villagers and she's just like...
Yeah, because apparently you get extra points for killing villagers.
There's games
who would have
like,
known?
Games like that?
Oh my god, yeah! There is like, there's one scene in a video game. I think it's one of the COD games. And don't look at me like this because I'm not too familiar with it, but like, there's a scene in an airport where you kill civilians.
Oh yeah!
That's like a whole thing. And like, you can opt out of playing that scene, but I'm like, why does it exist in the first place? And not to be like a Debbie Downer when it comes to, oh no, the violent video games. It's just like, I just don't see the point of that one specifically.
I think like
call
this,
me stupid.
I get that. I think like the Saints Row games, you can basically kill everybody.
Yeah.
Or even like Grand Theft Auto.
Yeah.
But that kind of does bothers me less because that's kind of like all of the games are like that. And it's kind of just like you do whatever you want.
Right.
Like I feel like if it's a game of like do whatever you want, it's fine. But like if it's like that kind of thing where it's like part of the narrative, that doesn't feel
yeah,
right.
Yeah, then it's weird to me. But what do I know?
Also, if you get the right...
I just like to play Pokemon. They don't die. They just faint.
Oh. Also, if you get the right mods in The Sims, you can kill everybody.
Oh my god, that's fun. Somehow playing God seems less, like, egregious than war crimes.
Fair.
Them run. They must die like the maggots that they are.
Yeah, Luke, what?
I didn't know we got extra points for killing villagers.
It's amazing. And I thought I knew everything about this game.
Just here for my Trekkies. Do it in the Final Frontier hat.
That's my hat.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Are you sure?
Yep.
Though your flirtation technique is hilarious, it's distracting. Luca is kicking serious ass right now. He just set fire to a farmer's market.
Oh my god.
Save your day. Save your tears for your dog mother in hell.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Wait a minute.
So Nipple Play War Criminal.
DVD, Blu-ray, disc. Kick Puncher 3, the final kickening.
What would happen if somebody broke
that's
that
a Blu-ray.
Rule?
He'd be dead to me forever.
Maybe we watch Kick Puncher 3, the final kickening together sometime.
Yes, Luca. Maybe we do. Maybe we do.
Would you please leave?
Bye.
I don't play anymore.
Britta comes into the room to kind of like... I guess, like, allude to, like, maybe, like, that Luke is a war criminal without saying that Luke is a war criminal.
Right, yeah.
And they're kind of like, just shut up and stop ruining him. And then she's like, and then Luke was like, you got Kick Puncher.
Yeah, and Kick like, Puncher 3.
Kick Puncher 3. And, like, he really wants to, like, borrow it. And then Abed's like, no, I don't let people borrow because of Sam Pearson.
Yeah.
So then Britta's like, oh, so, like, you would not be friends with somebody if they stole your DVD or they borrowed your DVD without asking. And yeah. He's like, yes. Mm. So then Britta's like, huh.
Interesting.
Wait, Kick Muncher 3?
Kick Muncher.
Wasn't that the movie that Luca was... You don't think.
You don't think.
Unless...
Well, I suppose, however...
No!
That would mean that you guys would have to stop hanging out. No!
We have video of you taking the DVD, Britta.
What?
Oh my god.
You have a security camera in your room?
It's for an extremely thorough documentary I'm making on my life. It's mostly footage of me watching dailies, but every once in a while it comes in handy.
I don't understand why you would do this and then try to pin it on Luca.
I did this so you guys would stop hanging out with him. He's a war criminal.
You're embarrassing yourself, Britta.
In what war is he a criminal?
The Balkans?
The battle for our affection?
How about the genocide in the Balkans?
Mm, yeah, you would say that. You just got caught red-handed borrowing a DVD without permission.
The worst crime.
It is the worst crime.
Basically, Troy and Abed, like, talk to Britta in the study room, and they're kind of like, somebody took my Kick Puncher 3 DVD,
mm-hmm.
and he's just calling, she's like, what? Who would do such thing? Do you think
say
it was
it
Luca?
So.
No,
and she's, like, trying to play it up very dramatically.
And they're like, and Abed's like, I have a camera in my room. I saw you take the DVD.
Yeah, like, they figured out easily. Like, it's very obvious.
And then they're like, why would you do such a thing?
Yeah.
Try to make us hate Luca. And she's like, he's a war criminal. And then they think that she's lying, and then they're really bad. Like, you just stole a DVD.
Right.
You monster.
Right. Which is the worst crime that you can commit.
Besides genocide.
Besides genocide.
So that didn't go well. And now everybody's kind of mad at each other in that sense. Mm-hmm. Then later on, Jeff is like coming back from a jog.
Illegal was El Nemo.
Yeah.
No, that's not how that works.
Hey,
hola.
What are you doing? Who are these tiny people?
I picked up Shirley's kids from school, and I'm helping them with their Spanish homework.
Why? To prove I'm a responsible dad.
This proves you're a kidnapper. What the hell's wrong with you?
I am nuts, Jeff. Get with the program.
Oh my god, what have I done? I can't believe I actually said you could be a father.
I can't be.
Oh no, you can. You can't be anything, and you never will. I protect.
Kill your mom, dumbass.
My mom's name's LaQuanda.
Hey, that's racist.
Wait.
Oh my god.
Yeah, you said you were a friend of hers. Why didn't you know that, dumbass?
Yeah, dumbass.
I do.
I want you to understand something while I'm gone. You are a horrible human being. And I will never feel sorry for you again. I don't care what happens to you. And when I get back, I want you gone.
Oh, believe me, I will definitely be far, far away from here.
Oh my god, he's got a call for a kid.
Hi, policeman.
Oh, it's terrible.
Here you go.
Hooray! Mm-hmm. And sees Chang with two black kids teaching them Spanish. And yeah. She's like, oh, I picked up like Shirley's kids from school. And I'm teaching them Spanish. And then he's like, so you kidnap them.
You kidnap children.
Right. And then Jeff's like, oh, crap. And then he's like, all right, I'm going to take you kids home. So then as he's leaving, the kids are like, who's Shirley?
Right. Because that's not their mom's name. Their mom's name is Laquanda. And they just got in Chang's car because Chang said he was a friend of their mom's. And they just believed him, which honestly, that's bad.
That's bad, kid.
If any children are watching this, I hope you're not, because you shouldn't be. But you can't, don't do that.
Don't, they say that, unless like you know them.
Unless you know who they are.
Or if your mom texts you saying, hey, this specific person who looks like this is going to pick you up.
Right.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Other than that, no.
Nope.
So then Jeff's like, let me take you home. And then he's like, Jeff's like, I can't believe I said you're going to be a good father. Like, you can't do anything. Get out of my house. Mm-hmm. And then Chang's like, fine, I'll be at your house. And then he calls the police.
Yeah, he tries to get revenge by now that Chang knows that they're straight up just like not the kids they thought they were. Now he's going to report Jeff for kidnapping.
Like you do?
Like you do.
So then I guess like Jeff spends the night in jail.
Your wallet, keys, and pasties. They're nipple guards for running. Olympic athletes use them.
Buddy, I worked at a maximum security prison for 7 years. And those are still the gayest thing I've ever seen.
Well, I find that hard to believe. Did you know you can make an ashtray using only a cigarette and a snitch's forehead?
Yeah.
Look, Shirley. Because if we put our heads together, we could be rid of him for 20 to life. Oh, absolutely. All I have to do is testify that he tried to sell those kids to me, and throw in the fact that he was teaching them Spanish, and any DA worth his salt can make a case for human trafficking.
I like how you take it.
Oh, my God.
What is wrong with you? Why are you doing this to Shane?
I'm doing this for us.
Maybe that's what you want the first time around.
Oh,
you did everything in your power to make everything perfect, and look what happened.
Are you trying to tell me you cheated because I wanted what was best for our family?
No, I cheated because I was a coward.
There,
okay.
But you took all me right. back because
while I was scared where that was going.
How you learned to accept the bad with the good.
But it went good.
Oh, that's the Greendale effect. Our school motto is lower your standards.
Right, but locking that little man up is not going to make our lives any less crazy. It'll only make prison crazier.
I guess you're right. It's impossible to keep the chaos from your lives. I mean, we learned that in that movie we saw with all those dinosaurs.
Jurassic Park?
No, it's complicated.
Okay, calm down. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry to you, Officer Baby.
Let's go, buddy.
Come on!
Officer Baby.
But then he's free to go because Shirley comes in and kind of says, like, I talked to the kid's mom. Like, they're not going to press, she's not going to press charges. We're fine. Mm-hmm. And then basically that's to find out because she gave up Chang.
Yeah.
So now Chang's arrested.
Mm-hmm.
And I do kind of like this like bit, like something like this bit kind of makes me like wish that there's kind of more of like a Jeff and Shirley shenanigans.
Yeah.
Cause he's like, cause she's like, oh, I was going to say, I said like, oh, like Chang can have a rogue, like, and then Jeff's like, he could go away for 3 to 5 years.
Yeah.
We work our things. If we work our brains together, we can get away from 20 to life. I see say that he's teaching him Spanish and like say that he's
they're trying to get him for human trafficking.
And then Andre's like, what do you... No!
Right. Andre has to step in and be the voice of reason and be like, guys, no.
He's like,
this
guys,
isn't
like,
the right move.
Like, we can't just keep everything perfect. That's what destroyed our marriage in the first place. And Shirley's like, wait, are you blaming me for...
Yeah, it almost comes off as that, like, he blamed her for leaving like, her. But he doesn't say that. Which
he's like, no, I cheated because I was a coward, which, like, fair.
It's like, okay, good. Because that made me nervous for a second.
Like, we need to just, like, embrace the chaos and just, like, whatever happens, happens. Like, I don't think about we were, like, saying, like, oh, like, I know you're ashamed of what up with Chang and I am, too. But I'm not sure if that was, like, because mm-hmm. of that or because, like, he's ashamed because he knows that his wife feels bad about it. So, like,
yeah, I think his shame is that, oh, him stepping out led his wife to do some very desperate things, fair. At least in their mind, because they don't know the circumstances of the situation. So he feels shame because his inadequacies led to that. I think that's where he stands. So,
growth,
maybe, perhaps,
baby steps. All right. So then they're like, all right, fine, and then they, I guess, help Chang get out of jail.
Yeah.
You guys want me to ruin something for you?
Yes.
Come on, you're being dramatic. We asked Luca a few questions after what you said.
That's terrible.
He told us about his time in the army and the things he did.
I'm never gonna get some of those images out of my head. If I ever go to the Balkans, I'm bringing some serious cheat codes and walkthroughs.
There's a difference between telling us a guy likes nipple play and telling us a guy makes hats out of babies.
Yes.
I guess the reason this happened is because we've been riding you kind of hard lately.
How about from now on, we promise to go easier on you if you promise not to tell us any details about the guys you're dating unless they've committed genocide.
Fair.
Or if they're left-handed, I want to know about that. I'm making a chart.
I tend to ruin stuff.
Yeah. Oh,
you do not.
You wanna watch Catfish with us?
Was that the movie where the guy flirts with the girl online, but then it turns out that it's a fat old woman? Sorry.
It's cool. It's about Catfish.
Aw. Aw, friendship. And then also Troy and Abed go into the study room and they ask Luca some questions, and it turns out that, like, oh, he is actually a war criminal who was a part of a genocide.
Yep.
It wasn't several genocides, I think it's just one.
One genocide, lots of people. A lot of people died.
I don't think I know much about the Balkan genocide.
I also don't know much about it, but... thing. It's like a whole thing. It's a whole
I feel like
thing.
There's too many genocides.
Yeah. Stop killing people.
Witty closes against genocide.
Witty closes against genocide.
We did it.
Yeah, we did it. We solved all the world's problems.
So then Abed and Troy basically apologize to Britta about, like, saying, like, hey, like, maybe, like, we agree that, like, we won't be so hard on you. And then also, like, you can tell, like, don't just basically, like, I won't tell you about, like, bunch of, like, things if I don't like a guy, except for if he's a war criminal.
Right, exactly. So, if they agree, they're like, oh, the reason that they went so long without knowing that is because she was trying to hide it. But there are things that you should tell your friends. So, you gotta, it's those healthy boundaries to right. set.
And then they're like, wanna go watch Catfish, and then Britta spoils Catfish.
Because she ruins everything. That's the joke. Or, like, when Troy and Abed walk in, and both Troy and Britta are wearing
the green.
Yeah, they're wearing, like, green scarves, and Britta's like, I ruin everything, and Troy's like, no, you don't, and he takes off the scarf because she's wearing it. So it is funny. Some funny little fashion moments. Also, we forgot to mention the sweatshirt. There's like a sweatshirt that Abed made that has. Paintball.
Yeah.
Jeff is wearing it on his run, which is very funny. Like, if you see him in jail, like, it has the saying on the back. On the back. So I thought that was really funny.
That's sweet.
Yeah. So I actually really like that.
The end.
The end. First gen iPad. Love it.
Well, this is fun.
Bye.
Bye, everybody.
So then the antagonist is everybody sitting at the study table mm-hmm. on their phones or, like, pads or, like, calculators.
Yeah.
We're doing whatever. And then Abed's like, all right, that was fun. Bye, guys.
That's how they hang out. Sometimes that's how you hang out with your friends.
Sometimes, like, that always made me feel like you're not actually hanging out with somebody. You're just, like, doing what you can do alone. But then I'm like, oh, well, I guess, like...
Sometimes you just need a chill hangout session. Sometimes, not all the time, just, like, once in a while.
My thing, like, I guess, like, I was always believe that, like, oh, like, in order to, like, hang out with somebody, you need to, like, talk to them. But I guess, mm-hmm. like, you can just, like, as long as you're on a couch together.
Yeah.
Then you're good. What did we learn today?
Genocide is bad.
Genocide is bad.
Don't kill people. If somebody you know has committed a genocide, maybe tell your friends. Don't kidnap children. Because that's bad. Don't try to put people in jail when they don't necessarily have to be.
And embrace the chaos?
Embrace the chaos. Embrace the chaos. Hooray. But also, please do not kidnap anybody. Thank you.
What did you think of this episode?
Especially children. It was a little crazy. It was good, though. It was, it was like anytime, you know, Shirley's drama gets brought up, it's like a more normal episode of Community, I feel right. like. But sometimes you need the normal thrown in there with all the other crazy stuff. So, mm-hmm. like, it was fine.
Did you like the subplot with the war criminal?
Oh, my God. That was a little like, oh, my God. It was funny, though.
So, yeah. I forgot the name of the actor, but I remember it was an episode of Law and Order SVU mm-hmm. where, like, he assaulted a woman and then tried to avoid the jail stuff. By murdering her ex and framing her.
Oh.
He got figured out. That was fine.
Okay, good.
Do you want some trivia?
I'd love some trivia.
Should I also say, like, I wonder, because, like, this episode kind of feels like, I feel like there's something more, like, there was, like, a specific point to the last episode, and this one kind of felt like more like a sitcom where there's a bunch of stuff going on at
once. Yeah, definitely.
Right. Shirley mentions Jurassic Park.
That was the
part. The life trip. So that's really meant Jurassic Park, but she meant it's complicated.
Yeah. Yeah, the movie with all the dinosaurs.
It's complicated.
It's complicated.
Tori and Abed invite Britta to watch Catfish. Did you ever see Catfish?
Not the movie.
Oh, you watch the show?
A couple episodes.
Oh, I never watched either. Anyway. Britta attempts to impress Luca with the Britney Spears song, but it comes out as a mashup of Baby One More Time and Genie in a Bottle.
Yep. It's bad. It's bad.
If you wanna be with me. Anyway. I don't know that makes me think of the Barbie game with the genie bottle, and you don't actually know how to play.
Oh, I don't know that one.
It came with the genie bottle. Oh. It's like one of those computer things, but I don't think I actually ever played it.
I actually love the computer games that like had the like attachment that you would put on a keyboard.
Oh yeah, I had one that was like a baking thing, so I had like a dough thing, and then like you connected to the thing, but like literally you had to like do a thing, and if anyone needs something, you just went in.
I had a Tonka truck one, except it was my brother's. But although, I
like speaking of gender toys, there was the baking one, and then there was a construction one.
Yeah, the construction one. That was.
I like baking stuff too. When I was
yeah.
Pierce calls Joe Kennedy his series' greatest chump.
Yeah.
Chang talks about recording phones on his VCR. Mm-hmm. Britta picks up a hat that Ovid said Trekkies do it in the Final Frontier.
Nice.
Jeff wonders why is everyone in the school obsessed with race? The answer is that community is created in Harmon by his own frequent admission that obsessed with race.
That's weird.
That kind of sounded like the way that we treat other races. Like, because I feel like there's like, it's like the history of it is interesting.
Yeah.
But like.
That's a weird self-admission.
Or like the fact that like we're all obsessed with it. Obsessed with the obsession.
Yeah.
Or like the fact that like when people try to like focus on it too much, it becomes racist.
Right. Yeah, there's a balance.
The sweatshirt commemorating the paintball game has "It's all downhill from here" written on the back. This might be a reference to some comments about the decline in quality in season 2.
Nice.
The anti could be assumed for the fact that we never see the study group actually study in the study room. The community, the complete second season DVD commentary writer, Andy Bauro, revealed that the tag originally ended with Jeff giving Britta a birthday card and everyone leave, but that part was cut out after they realized it wasn't the right time of the year for a birthday.
Nice.
Trivia, other trivia. The flag Annie is waving was while discussing the. She said it was from Ghana, yeah. But it was the flag of Zimbabwe.
Oh no!
The food mentioned that the dean eats melipa.
Melipa.
Sorry.
Yeah, sorry.
Is from Southern Africa countries, including Zimbabwe. But that kind of makes me. I don't know if it's like a funny, not funny. It's not funny, but like a thing of like, oh, like I know these countries, and then you're like, oh yeah, like this person's from. God, if I'm gonna get this up, then they're like, that's Zimbabwe.
Yeah. You're like, that's not it. You're like, no. Oh, damn it.
Comment corner?
It's time for a comment corner. Did I remember where we were?
Oh, I was watching this and I forgot.
And we were literally, I just pulled up the episode. Nice. Mixology certifications.
Hooray!
We did it. I said it out loud.
Oh, did we have the Christmas stuff? Or no, we're starting with mixology certifications.
We're starting with mixology certifications.
Great.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh, I did say it right.
Okay, cool.
I got the reaction episode names correct. It's not the one for this recording.
Oh, nice.
Comment video. Can I rename that in audition or do I have to?
You can. Sure.
All right. Rename it. We're done recording.
Yeah, like once everything's saved and closed out, go back and do it.
All right.
Let's see. We're going to read the comments for mixology certifications.
Yeah.
Let's do it. All right. Anyway. McFine comments and says, still feels so weird whenever it comes up that the American drinking age is 21. That could be a few years into college. It was... my very last semester of college, because I was younger than most people in my class. Because you're a
baby. No, when I was my, I think it was a junior.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, I was a junior in college when I turned, the summer before we started junior year, yeah. I turned 21.
Yeah.
Because you're a baby.
I'm a baby, and you're older than me.
Don't remind me, I'm older than everybody.
That's okay, not everybody.
I'm older than all my friends, but yet I'm shorter than them.
Nice. Just gotta take it where you can get it. So there's just an exchange here, and Maxwell Long says, to be clear, just about everyone has tried alcohol before 21. That's how it usually works in the States.
Yeah.
And somehow everyone has access to it, even though no one can legally purchase it. It's a weird phenomenon.
I mean, anyway. Usually, like, your parents have it. I think that's, I don't know if it's actually
everyone has, like, the older sibling or somebody they know that can get it for them.
Some people say that, like, if you, like, have your kids, like, experience it early, they're not going to be willing to drink it mm-hmm. when they get older or, like... Like, I think it's, like, you get crazy, like, in before you can legally drink, and then once you can legally drink, it becomes less fun.
Yeah, right.
Because it's not, like, you're not going to get caught for anything.
Yeah, and our buddy Zom says, funnily enough, in some states, the legal age is 16, but requires parental supervision. So that is true. Sabo says, yeah, I don't rewatch this episode often because I don't feel it is as funny as the others, but it is great that it has a lot of development for the characters' personalities. That is true. And Zom says, oh, we were talking about, because there's a comment about what Chinese zodiac everyone is. Zom says, I too am the year of a dog. Represent, Zom. Born in
what year is it this year?
Rabbit.
Cool.
It's the year of the rabbit. Enjoy Your Rabbit, which is a album by Sufjan Stevens. Anyway, John Burita says, you two are the first community reactors to recognize Tig Notaro.
Really?
That sounds like a crime. How did nobody else recognize Tig Notaro?
I know she's not, like, she's not
huge, but she's been in a lot of stuff.
I know.
Yeah, and she's, like, a cult comedian.
She has a whole documentary about her.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. And then made a comment about John Oliver. And Zom says, I mean, John Oliver is hit and miss. I'm not going to be mad over who you listen to. Y'all are pretty civil. Thank you.
We are. Or we try to be.
We try to be. So that was mixology certifications. And then we're also going to read Abed's Uncontrollable Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Not a lot of comments on this one, surprisingly. I thought it was a good episode, though. We had fun, at least.
We had fun.
Oh, actually, a lot of upvotes. Oh my gosh, a lot of upvotes on these comments. So Sabo says, Christmas time sure is. Nano says, perfectly planned for December 9th. Cool, cool, cool. I'm really glad that you guys noticed that everything lined up really well, because we were really proud of
that. It
was
like the conspiracy episode where that lined up on Lafayette Independence Day, which we didn't try to do, but this one we tried.
Yeah.
That was like an effort.
We did, and it worked out really nice. And then Vicky Turner says, I really appreciate that this did come out on December 9th, and 10 people upvoted that. So we didn't get a lot of comments, but we did get a lot of upvotes.
Engagement.
So engagement. Thank you. We appreciate the engagement. And that's all for this comment corner. We'll read some more, of course, on the next episode.
So. All right. I also realized I forgot to do the tag over our social media.
That's okay. That's okay.
Beginning. I'll just put it up before the thing. Anyway, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, Patreon, Gmail, Spotify, iTunes, comment, subscribe, like, review, rate, share, give us money.
Thank you.
And we will vlog from the Watergate
and
Hotel.
Give us enough money and we will spend a night in the scandal room at the Watergate. Please, actually, I think that has become a new goal of mine.
Oh my god, we need to do that.
That has genuinely become a new goal of mine. I actually think that would be really funny. I wonder how many, there's gotta be a lot of vlogs doing that. I'm not gonna look this up as we're on camera, but as soon as we live, I'm gonna look to see how many YouTube vlogs are.
Yeah.
I spent a night at the Watergate scandal room. Anyway, okay, so
that's it for this episode. Join us next time. We're going to be discussing critical film studies.
Ooh.
And competitive wine tasting.
Ooh, sounds fun.
Or comparative? Competitive,
yes.
Right. Nice. I know words. Anyway, so for First Reaction Fan Reaction, I'm Dar Whitman.
I'm Kayla Clother.
Peace. No.
This is from me and Troy. When your child is a lone scavenger of the nuclear wasteland, clean water will be worth its weight in gold.
Yeah, we wanted to get him a sawed-off shotgun, but those were pretty expensive already.
Sorry. Oh, who am I kidding? I should be putting this right on my thighs.
Why do I have to put the VCR on 3 if Bones is on 5?
Why do you have a VCR?
Good stuff.
Good stuff. Ready to talk about it?
Let's talk about it.
Here you go.
I leave.
Bye.
Bye.